Hi people, you're welcome to ProUp Masterclass. My name is Tola Labi. Today I'm going to be sharing with you books you really need to get as a logo designer. Now this class was basically inspired by an email I got from Osaka Solomon, and he asked me, he said, I want to upgrade my logo design skills, but every time I do research, I come short of materials because I don't know where to begin. How and where do I get the right materials to read and help me? Now that's a really good question, and that inspired me to come up with this class. Now, I'm not only going to be sharing with you where to get the material, but I'm going to be sharing with you the materials you actually need. Now, I believe a lot of times we as designers choose the wrong mentors. We get mentored by the wrong people, and that happens nowadays. I talk with some people and I ask them, who are your mentors? And they say, some guy on Instagram. And why is he your mentor? Because he has 2 million followers and he does really good looking logos. And this guy might just be some teenage boy in the US or in the UK, wherever it might be, and he might even have less design experience than you do, just has better technical skills than you do. He might really not have any client relationship experience, no business experience, no finance experience, no long-term design experience. And you must be mentored by the right people if you're going to do design the right way. I always try to pick my mentors carefully. I like to get design mentorship by people that have been in the business of design for years, people that have been there for 40, 50 years. Some of them are even long gone. They've done design for over 70 years and they've passed on. You see, these guys have a wealth of knowledge that we need to tap into. It's not just about what looks good. It's about tapping into the journey of these people and knowing what their thought process was like when they went through their project. So today, I'm going to be sharing my design library and why I chose some of these books. Now, books are very important. A lot of people try to replace books with Facebook pages of designers and Instagram pages of designers. Well, those are good to get inspiration, but sometimes you just need to read as a designer. So I'm going to go through some of the books I have in my library as a designer, and hopefully it's going to be a lot of help to you. Now, the first book we're going to be looking at is Logo Lounge. Logo Lounge. Now, this is one of the first design books I ever got. It's by Bill Gardner, and it comes in quite a number of volumes. I don't even know what volume this is, but I think they have like 13 or so volumes, not to 20. But I know they revised the book a lot, and it's a really great resource for a logo designer. As I said, it was one of the first design books I ever got, and it's really cool. It's more or less a lookbook because it just shows you the logos, and right by the side you can see the companies that handle these logo designs, and it's a great book. It's a great book. One thing I really like about it is it categorizes logos, and here you can see you have logos in initials, typography, enclosure, calligraphy, crest, sports, heads, people, mythology, you know, just various types of logos. It's an amazing book, and if you're a designer and you've ever gotten your logo into this book, then you've done something really good, because I think they have a very, very amazing vetting process of getting a rich variety of logos. So I always take a look at this book whenever I need inspiration, and it's been of immense help to me. So Logo Lounge, it's a great book. Second book is Logo Design Love. Now this is a great book. It's a great, I can read this book over and over and over again. It's by David Airy, and it's It's an amazing book. It's an easy read and it's a very down-to-earth book. It makes you know that design is just, the process of design is universal. He really did his research on this book, Logo Design Love. He has revised the book quite a number of times. I think maybe two times, or maybe not quite a number of times, but it's an amazing book. It's a book that will always be relevant. I can see people 40 years from now still reading this book. It's a very good resource. It answers a lot of design questions, a lot of business questions, a lot of technical questions. And when you read this book, the feeling you have that you're not alone in this world as a designer. Other people are going through the same things you're going through as a designer. So Logo Design Love by David Airy, good book, wonderful book. Get it if you can. 100 Things Every Designer Needs to Know About People. Now, I've won a lot of my clients and I've sold a lot of my logo designs with the knowledge I've gotten from this book. This book was written by a design psychologist, and it's a psychology book, actually. It tells you a lot of things that you do not take into cognizance as a designer, but things that are really important in getting your work across or selling your idea to a client. Although it focuses a lot on web design and how to select colors and fonts and things for web design, but you can apply the concept to logo design also. I've learned a lot from this book. It talks about peripheral vision, your central vision, all these things, all these little things that you can just sneak up on a client and the client just buys your idea. It's an amazing book. 100 Things Every Designer Needs to Know About People. The next book I'm going to be talking about is Symbol. Symbol. Now, anyone that's following me on Instagram or Facebook, you know I've spoken about this book quite a number of times because I'm such a big fan of the book. It's a lookbook too. It's a good book. It's written by two designers. Their names are, let me get my name here, Angus Highland and Steve Bateman. Now, these two guys work with Pentagram. And Pentagram is one of the biggest design agencies in the world today. It's a gallery of symbols. And if you're into symbol marks, then you would love this book. It gives you great inspiration as a designer. It's a great book. And I like the fact that all the logos, or most of them, are in black and white. So you get to understand the simplicity of logos and how logos should work in black and white if the mark is going to endure at all. So Symbol is a real good book. I've given it out a lot to a lot of designers I mentor, and I said I'm going to stop giving it out right now because the book has really taken a beating, but it's a good book. Marks of Excellence by Per Mollerup. Now this book is a really good design book. It's one of those books that you read to understand branding and logo design. It was written by a man called Per Mollerup. Now, Per Mollerup is a Danish designer. He's a professor of design, so he's very academic. And I read this book a lot to just teach me how to talk about design. It's a great book. If you look through this book, you would see that I actually marked a lot of pages with my highlighter. But it's a great book. It's like a Bible when I read it, because it talks about the history of design, where design started from, and when I say design, I mean branding and logos and things like that. And it's a very in-depth book. It's a good book for anyone who wants to know how to talk about design and talk about design in detail. It features a lot of logos we see right now. You can see the 3M logo right there. There are so many logos that are featured here, and it really goes to huge lengths to let you know the history of these logos and the thought process of the designers that made these logos. It's an amazing book. It's a very big book, so it's not something you carry around. It's a book you read at your convenience. So it's a good book. Marks of Excellence by Per Mollerup, The History and Taxonomy of Trademarks. So So get this book if you can. It's a good book. Now, the last book I'll be showing you is Identify by Chemoyev and Geismar. Now, this is actually my best design book because these guys are my mentors. These people have been doing design for over 40 years now, and they're an amazing design company, amazing designers. They did the Mobil logo, they did the National Geographic logo, Amani Exchange logo, Chase Bank logo, MacArthur Foundation logo. They've done nearly everything. They are a great design company, and as I said, I consider them my design mentors. It's a great book. And when a company that did the Mobil logo, did National Geographic logo, writes a book, what do you do as a designer? You buy that book. You buy that book because you really want to hear from them. You want to read their experience. And they really went down to earth with this book. They talked about how some of their jobs were rejected at the onset, and how some of them were not well accepted, but the client grudgingly took them, and today the client love their logos. So it's a very down-to-earth book. It features a lot of amazing logos. Now I'm going to show you. I'm going to try to show you a logo here. Now, when last did you see a logo that looks like this? That is as freehand and as emotional as this. Now, most of today's logos look very geometric, and everyone is using what they call the golden ratio right now, and it's like a fad. Everybody's doing it, the golden ratio. It's almost like if you present your logo and you don't have those circles running through it, you haven't done any work. Now the golden ratio is good. It's nice, but you know, some people just use it and it still doesn't work for them. Your logo still doesn't look good, still doesn't look functional. They just use the golden ratio and it just seems like just for the heck of it, just doing it for the heck of it. Now, I must be honest with you. Personally, I don't use the golden ratio. If that makes me less professional, I don't know, but I think I do pretty awesome work. But we have to, as designers, try to trace our steps back and try to study some of this older generation designers and not get stuck in using design as a means of executing trend every now and then. Try to go out there and get a book by Chemoyev and Geismar, get a book by Saul Bass, get a book by Paul Rand. You know, these are guys that have had a lifetime of doing design, and there's so much to learn from them that we can pass on to the next generation. So this book, Identify, is a real amazing book. And I think something that a lot of these books that I've shared are books that we should try to get our hands on as designers. I really feel that design has become so generic nowadays that everybody's design kind of looks like the next person's design, because everybody's going to some Instagram page to see some beautifully designed logos and everybody wants to design like that. But you know, we must know that, number one, logo design, branding, one of the major objectives is to stand out and to be memorable. Now, how many of your designs are memorable? And how many of them can you actually remember that I saw this mark? And that's why designers like Stefan Stagmeister stands out. Someone like David Carson stands out. These guys do very out-of-the-box designs. And I think we as designers should more or less try to find our voice, our style of design, come up with your style of design that is outside the box and is not generic. So those are some of the books I would just like to share with you, and I hope you've been inspired. Now, I'll come back. I said I was going to tell you how to get some of these books. Now, I got most of these books on Amazon. Now, make use of Amazon. Amazon is an amazing platform where you can get resources. I get most of my books off Amazon. I order off Amazon and I get them delivered to me. Now, if people ask me, how do you get your books? Now, there's so many ways. You could walk into a bookstore, and some of the books, like the logo lounge, I got from from a bookstore. I just walked in the bookstore and I saw the book, and I said it's the first design book I ever got. And it was pretty much the only design book they had. And I bought it, and it was a helpful resource. So walk into a bookstore, ask them if they have a section for design books, graphic design books, logo books, and you'll be surprised what you'll be able to get from there. Get creative in how you can get books. The book I shared with you, The Marks of Excellence, it's the one by Perlmutter Roth, is this book has a very, very interesting story to it, because I did a job for a client abroad, and he wanted to pay me, and I told him, look, I'll do this job, but I don't want you to pay me. I want you to buy me this book and send it to me. And he was like, am I sure? I said, yes, I'm pretty sure. I want you to buy that book, and that will be our payment, and will be cool. And I did the job for him. I did logo design for him, and he was more than happy to get me the book, and he sent me the book. So that's the story behind that. So get creative, you know, get creative. You have people traveling abroad every day. If you can't get it here, give them money and let them get you these books. Let them get you these resources. Read as much as possible to improve your skill as a designer. So hope you found this class helpful. If you have, please leave a comment. If you have other books you want to share with me, please leave a comment. And if you have other questions you'd like to ask, leave a comment. If you would like us to talk about a particular topic on the business of design, please leave a comment. Don't forget to click the subscribe button and share this video. I'll see you in the next class.